morning, everyone. It is my great pleasure to welcome each of you to our 46th commencement ceremony. I am Ronald Mason, Jr., President of the University of the District of Columbia, the public institution of higher learning in and for the nation's capital. Before we begin, I'd like to get something off my mind before we get to the program, because my family surprised me this morning. Knocked on a door and said it was the laundry, dry cleaning, but it was them. Okay, stand up, please, guys. My children, my wife, and then the other big surprise was that my youngest son told me that his partner is pregnant with my first grandchild. And so if I flub a few lines, you know it's because I'm a little discombobulated today, okay? Now, I'm especially pleased to recognize members of our Board of Trustees, Chairman Christopher Bell, Vice Chairman Yon Clyburn, Secretary Dr. Esther Barazone, Treasurer Jerome Shelton, the Honorable Dr. Charlene Drew Jarvis, retired Major General Errol Schwartz, Dr. Mildred Musgrove, Dr. Carolyn Rudd, Anthony Tard, Mr. Barrington Scott, Mr. Ken Grossinger, Ms. Antoinette White Richardson, and our student representative to the board, Dr. Tanya Harris. To the honorary degree recipient, faculty, staff, alumni, friends, and other distinguished guests, thank you for joining us today to celebrate the class of 2023. To the class, those who have gathered here at the Walter E. Washington Convention Center to celebrate, you should have tremendous pride in your accomplishments, as do the many around the world who are with us virtually through live streaming of today's ceremony. Again, welcome to those online, the many thousands who are watching this live stream. The University of the District of Columbia is an institution with a remarkable history that is steeped in traditions of quality and excellence dating back to 1851. It was created by Congress, but it is in every sense a creature of the district. Its legacy makes it mission-driven to serve. It is a land-grant institution, but unlike other colleges and universities in that category, which were designed to serve and educate primarily rural communities, UDC's service area is entirely urban, the District of Columbia. The overarching vision of the University of the District of Columbia is for our students to reach their highest levels of human potential. From professional certifications to doctoral and professional degrees, we provide our students with multiple pathways to success. So, today is about the fruit of our labor, our graduates. This is your moment. Today we validate your aspirations and recognize all you have accomplished and achieved. Today we celebrate you. Ladies and gentlemen, give our graduates a big round of applause. Graduates, please stand and thank your loved ones for their sacrifice and support. Now I ask you to show your appreciation for those who have stood by you throughout your time. Your parents, your families, friends, spouses, partners, and loved ones, it's time for you to salute them. Will the audience, that is those who are able, please rise and remain standing for the presentation of colors by members of the District of Columbia Fire and EMS Honor Guard. We extend our sincere appreciation for their participation. Following presentation of the colors, we ask that everyone join the University of the District of Columbia's outstanding chorale, led by Professor Johnny Butler and accompanied by Professor Evelyn Simpson Curinton on piano, in singing of the Star-Spangled Banner. After the retirement of colors, we ask that you remain standing for the invocation by Reverend John P. Goodlow, UDC class of 1970.
Over 50 years ago, I stood and then sat in seats like you are standing and sitting. The diversity of the crowd was large then. The diversity of the crowd is exponentially large now. And because of that, I ask that you would with me, as I pray in my tradition, I invite you to pray in that tradition that is yours at this time. Shall we? Sovereign God, you are altogether lovely. We thank you for what you have done in blessing us to come to this place, to have an opportunity to celebrate you first. We're grateful for life itself. And so we honor you, we reverend you, we recognize that you ought to be hallowed. And so we first say thank you, O God. We now say also thank you to those who have assisted us in reaching this place, this point in our lives, so that we might be able to say that yes, indeed, we have achieved. And because of this, we realize that we did not do this on our own. And so we say thank you to parents and family. We say thank you to friends. We say thank you to professors. We say thank you to counselors, to administrators. And we, O God, again, honor you making all of this possible. We ask now, O God, that as we go from this place, commencing another level of our lives, another level of our education, that you would guide us, that you would direct us, and that you would show us, O God, what it is that you would have us to do. For when we do it your way, you have told us in your word that when we speak your words, when we, O God, walk in the way that you want us to walk, and when we bring pleasure to your great name, we then are honoring and we then are delighting ourselves in you. And your word says, when we do that, you will give us the desires of our heart. Bless those who will speak. We thank you for the congressman who is here, for his family. We thank you, O God, for those who will lead in the rest of this program. And so we invoke your presence. And again, we honor, O God, these graduates. Now, Lord, we ask now that as it is the tradition of all of us, in praying as you would have us to pray, I do pray in my tradition, in the name of Jesus, let us all say, amen. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, we ask those who can stand and join the UDC, the University of the District of Columbia Chorale, in singing the immortal words of Lift Every Voice and Sing, found on page 32 in your program. Would you do that, please?
Road we trod, bitter and chastening rod, felt in the days when
That was beautiful renditions of both national anthems. Why don't we give them one more hand? Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pleasure that I now present Mr. Christopher Bell, Chairman of the Board of Trustees of the University of the District of Columbia. He will deliver the official welcome on behalf of the university's Board of Trustees.
Good morning. As a trustee of this great institution, it is truly an honor to be here with you today. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, the faculty, administration, and staff, welcome to this ceremony honoring our graduates. We gather here today to acknowledge and celebrate this major accomplishment, the college graduation of the class of 2023. A special message to the family and friends of our graduates. The role you have played in the educational journey of these candidates during a global pandemic has been an important one. Your care, your sacrifice, and support have contributed to their success. You share in the congratulations received by all of our degree candidates today. To all of the graduates, thank you for the contributions you have made to our diverse educational community. Whether it has been at the Van Ness campus or the community college or with one of our community partners, you've added significantly to the life of the university in and out of the classroom. May you continue to meet the responsibilities and challenges of the future through lifelong learning, service, leadership, and ethical diversity. As a global citizen, we know that you will contribute to the betterment of this world. The trustees look forward to our continued association as you officially become alumni of the great institution today. And again, congratulations on this, your commencement day, from the University of the District of Columbia. I'd like to take a little bit of license at this time also to acknowledge an outstanding and wonderful leader of this university, President Mason. President Mason, this is his last graduation as president of the university, but on behalf of the Board of Trustees and faculty administration, I want to say from the bottom of my heart, thank you for everything that you have done for this university. When he came here 8 years ago, this university was a different place, and now that he's leaving, it's in another different place. We are proud, we are flying, we are firebirds, and we are so proud of the leadership and the dedication and energy and vision that he has shown to this university. So again, President Mason, and to your beautiful family here, thank you so much for everything that you have done.
Well, thank you for that, Chairman. I'm honored to recognize the Grand Marshal for our 2023 commencement ceremony, Professor Pradeep Behera. He is a regarded faculty member who teaches mechanical engineering in the School of Engineering and Applied Sciences. Thank you, Professor Behera. I would also like, you can give him a hand if you like, that's fine. I would also like to introduce our faculty and student leaders. Please stand when your name is called. Professor Andrea Adams, Acting Chair of the Faculty Senate. Brent Thigpen, President of the Undergraduate Student Association. Chanel Hibbert, President of the Graduate Student Association. Nigel Bastfield, President of the Student Bar Association. Darshaquia Smith, President of the UDC Community College Student Government. And Dr. Tanya Harris, Student Representative to the Board of Trustees. Let's give them all a round of applause. I'd also like to ask our guests to join with our graduates in recognizing the UDC faculty. These dedicated and distinguished men and women, renowned scholars, researchers, and mentors share a deep commitment to bringing out the very best in our students. Thank you very much, all of you, for what you do. Give them a hand, please. I'd like to take a moment of presidential privilege to extend my gratitude to our faculty retirees who have provided wisdom, mentoring, and guidance to thousands of students across the years. They have more than 226 years of teaching experience at the University of the District of Columbia. Let's give them all a big round of applause. And of course, central as they are, our faculty cannot do it alone. They are part of a larger, warm, and hardworking UDC community. This includes our trustees, our staff, our alumni, and the many volunteers who put their hearts and souls into making this day possible. And it also includes our honored commencement guests who joined the UDC family today. Thank you. Finally, please join me in a moment of silence for those in the Firebird Nation who have transitioned this year. We will now proceed with the awarding of our honorary degree.
President Mason, the Board of Trustees of the University of the District of Columbia authorizes you to confer honorary doctorate degree upon the designated candidate in recognition of their achievements in their respective fields. Will Congressman Maxwell Alejandro Frost, candidate for the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, please rise and come to the podium. Mr. President, I have the honor to present the Honorable Maxwell Alejandro Frost, a candidate for the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters.
Thus, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the University of the District of Columbia, I do hereby confer upon Maxwell Alejandro Frost, Doctor of Humane Letters, with all honors, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. Please welcome the UDC Chorale as they sing Rockin' Jerusalem.
Ring them bells, boy. Hear them ring. ring in, for they are up in Jerusalem, from in Jerusalem, in Jerusalem, ring in the bells, from in Jerusalem, from in Jerusalem, from in Jerusalem, ring in the bells.
Please. We have had many famous commencement speakers over the years, but I am most honored and pleased to introduce our speaker for today. You can read his bio in the program. However, I would like to depart from the script and introduce him as follows. Our nation is at a tipping point. The answer to the question of whether the idea that we call the United States of America, a land of many land and people of many peoples, where all have inalienable rights, that idea hangs in the balance. It is sometimes difficult to be optimistic about achieving the dream of America when we are bombarded each day with efforts to disenfranchise voters, sanitize history, undo elections, and besiege the House of Congress. Voices that see America as a place where race and social status determines one's ability to enjoy life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness are given the largest stage. However, there are other voices, voices that speak the truth clearly and simply in a world consumed by lies. I believe the University of the District of Columbia, the only public institution in the nation's capital, a historically black university, and the nation's only exclusively urban land-grant institution, is responsible for being such a voice. That is why it was founded on the 200th anniversary of the Declaration of Independence. Thus, with great intentionality, we sought out today's speaker. We did so for two reasons. First, because he speaks truth to power. He does not seem to do so for gain or glory. Rather, he seems to do so simply because truth needs to be said and heard in the halls of power. And we believe his voice should be heard as often and as clearly as possible. The second reason is that he was born in 1997, and we expect his voice to grow stronger and stronger over time. Furthermore, if he is representative of his generation, then there really is hope for the future. When he looks back on what he did to make the world a better place, We want part of his early memories to be this commencement, and that he became part of the Firebird Nation, and that the public institution in and for the nation's capital is his intellectual home and safe haven wherever and wherever he wields the sword of truth. Ladies and gentlemen, class of 2023, it is my direct honor, my distinct honor and privilege to present to you Congressman Maxwell Alejandro Frost.
Good morning. How's everybody doing? It is a blessing to be here. I am so honored to be here today and honored to receive this honorary doctorate degree and thankful to be here with the Firebird Nation on this momentous day. My name is Maxwell Alejandro Frost. I'm a proud representative of Florida's 10th Congressional District in the United States Congress, proudly the youngest member of the United States Congress and the first member of Generation Z to be in those halls of power. And before I start, I gotta ask, what's the word?
Firebird.
What's the word?
Firebird.
What's the word?
Firebird.
All right, I love it. The honor of being chosen as your commencement speaker is not something I take lightly. And I wanna thank the University of the District of Columbia for having me here today with all of you. And I'm also honored to be here as today's commencement speaker, as it's the start of a new chapter for so many in this room, including UDC's own president, who is ending his tenure as the longest serving president in the history of this esteemed historic establishment. President Ronald Mason Jr. truly blazed the trail here. Under his leadership, this institution has created not one, but two PhD programs, secured millions in funding to improve school and improve student quality of life, and expanded workforce development programs. And while we know this isn't a goodbye and simply a see you later for President Mason, let's give him a warm round of applause for his leadership here in this time. I also got to go off script a little bit to honor my mother, who is here today in the front row. Today is her birthday. Happy birthday, Mom. In just a few weeks, my mother will retire after 37 years of service as a public school educator teaching special needs children. She came here in the late 1960s from Cuba with no money and no English, and today she got to see her son receive an honorary PhD from one of our nation's most esteemed institutions. Graduates, congratulations. As we all know, we live in some very dangerous times, but also exciting times. The rise in authoritarianism and fascism across this country stems directly from the rise of black political power in this country. The rise in fascism in this country is a direct response from the rise of the power of young people in this country. And across the United States, and especially in my home state of Florida, I used to joke and say we were the free state of Florida. Now I just say we're the beautiful state of Florida, because we are a beautiful state, but not so free. Black history is being erased, books are being banned, immigrants are being oppressed, and to be honest, things can seem pretty damn hopeless. But what's kept me in this fight over the past decade of my life are the people who have stepped into their power. And so without further ado, graduates, you thought you were done, but you got one more 10-minute course that was just approved by the president. It is Stepping Into Your Power 101 with Congressman and Honorary Doctor Maxwell Frost. Welcome to class. You know, Forbes said that no one can gift you power, but that true authentic power comes from within us. And to me, that means stopping out of the sidelines, stepping into your community and fighting for your voice, for your values, for your beliefs, but most importantly, for the rights of others to have a voice and live out their values and beliefs as well. And you know, as an organizer, I truly believe that the most powerful asset that we have is our story. My story started over a decade ago when I started organizing at the age of 15 years old for one simple reason. I didn't want to get shot in school. I went to an arts middle school and high school where I studied jazz drums. It wasn't exactly like High School Musical. Imagine High School Musical, but like 70% Latinos and black folks, so it was better. Before every show, my best friends and I would go to this Fridays across the street. We'd always load up on junk food before our concert. You know we were on that 2 for $20. You know how much high schoolers love microwave chicken. And that's what we were on. It was a tradition. So we're there eating, and there's a silence that falls across the entire restaurant. We're a little confused. We look around, we look at each other, and we finally look up at the television screens and see somebody walked into an elementary school in Newtown, Connecticut, murdered 20 children and 6 teachers. I remember my heart dropping, and I watched that coverage, seeing those kids walk out of that elementary school with their hands in the air and their little book bags and the fear of their eyes. That was over 10 years ago, but I still remember going back to school, going back to the jazz show, and not being able to play right because I kept looking over my shoulders at the exit signs because I was scared somebody was gonna walk into the school in that auditorium and deliver that same fate to my friends and my family. And so I ended up coming to a memorial. It was my first time here in Washington, D.C. I got to spend a lot of time with the kids who lost family members in that shooting. And seeing 6 and 16-year-olds with the demeanor of 60-year-olds crying over their dead family members changed my life forever. And it was that night that I dedicated the rest of my life to fighting for a better world. From there, I got involved in the fight to end gun violence at home, started working on campaigns straight out of high school, was proud to work at organizations such as the ACLU and March for Our Lives, and then in 2021, I was approached by some friends that I had been tear gassed, arrested, and went to jail with during the Black Lives Matter uprising. And they encouraged me to run for office. And I remember exactly what I said because it was only 2 words. Hell no. You know, I had internalized what my future opponents would say about me. I'm too young. I'm not ready. It's not my turn. I don't have the experience. I don't look like a congressperson. But after connecting with folks in my community and learning that people were yearning for bold, progressive representation, it gave me confidence I didn't even see in myself. Because we have this caricature of what a politician is and what they look like. They didn't look like me. They didn't sound like me. And little by little, I realized that was the problem. I mean, when I say the word politician, what do you think of? That's not rhetorical. Say it out loud. What do you think of? Old white men. Anything else? Corrupt. I mean, with this news about George Santos, I think about jail. And see, it's funny, but it's also incredibly sad because we're talking about our leaders. And so instead of running away from what I knew was negative, I wanted to be a part of the solution about making power work for every single one of us. You know, growing up, I was a little bit of a troublemaker. Every time I'm with my mom and I tell someone about the troublemaking I used to do, she'd always say, he wasn't that bad. And I'm like, you're such a good mom. I wasn't bad. I like to make people laugh. I talk too much. Now it's my job to talk too much. But one of my old teachers actually told me just a few months ago that I had spent roughly 75% of my 6th grade year in detention. Now, for all the middle schoolers and high schoolers here, don't go home, don't start going to detention, and don't start telling your parents Maxwell Frost told you to. That's not the moral of the story here. But I gotta tell you, hearing that number reminded me that part of the reason I'm here today is because of the second chances and grace that the people in my life gave me. Because I know that many of you here today probably second guess yourself. And I am who I am because somebody loved me. I am who I am because somebody loved me. And I gotta say, it's not just about the grace that others give you, it's about the grace you give yourself. You know, growing up, I always made these long-term goals. I had a one-year plan, a five-year plan, a 10-year plan, a 20-year plan, and none of them happened. And my life changed when I stopped focusing my goals on who I wanted to be, but rather what I wanted to do. See, it shouldn't be about sitting in a specific seat of power or being the CEO of a specific company. Your goal should be about your impact, what you want to do in this world. And believe it or not, contrary to what we might be told as we're growing up, when you set goals that are about action versus position, it actually sets you up for success because it gives you the grace that you deserve to do what you want to do in your life. My goal is simple. In my life, I want to help people through music and politics. That's it. That's my goal. And as long as I wake up every morning making decisions in service of that, I can be proud of myself. To step into your own power, you have to give yourself grace. I often think about why, over a year and a half ago, did I dismiss the notion of running for office when people told me to? And the reason why is because I was content to hold my power in places and spaces where it was permitted by a society that had historically tried to keep me, people who look like me, people who look like us, working people, out of positions of power. I dismissed it because despite the fact that I felt ready, I knew that I was ready, and I knew what my community needed, but I didn't believe that anyone would put their faith in me. Because after all, who would put their faith in, at the time, a 25-year-old Black Afro-Latino, still working on his college degree, with too many opinions on how the world could be better, but not enough lived experience to back it up. But up until that moment, I was content with stepping into my power only in the way that society deemed acceptable. But the truth is, deep down, I knew I was ready. And for every person who doubted that I could energize the state of Florida in a place where our governor stomps around, acting like an autocrat, pushing an anti-Black, anti-woman, anti-LGBTQ+, anti-American agenda, I knew I was ready. For every person who criticized my age and said I didn't have enough experience, I knew I was ready. But I realized that having the knowledge, having the know-how, is only half of the equation of stepping into your power. The other half is actually using it. So my message is simple. For all the graduates here today, it doesn't matter what you go into. Use your power. If you go into education, use your power to teach true history and help educate both the future and the present of this country. If you go into the arts, use your power to create a better world through your soul craft, because a lot of times artists and people will say art is an escape from reality. It's not an escape from reality, it is our reality, and that's what you create as an artist. If you go into politics, use your power to fight the status quo and don't get bogged down just because that's the way things have always been. Because if previous freedom fighters thought the same way, none of us would be sitting here today. And if you go into business, use it. Use your power to look out for your employees, to ensure no one is exploited, and that we take care of our planet. See, to impact this world in a positive way, you don't have to run for office. I encourage many of you to, though. You know, it's funny, when you get into Congress, the first thing you say is you look around and you go, how'd I get here? And then you meet some of your colleagues and you go, how the hell did they get here? My message is this: use your power and see the world through the eyes of the most vulnerable in everything that you do, no matter where you go, because that's why I'm so hopeful for this country. It's not about Democrats versus Republicans. It's about the people versus the problem. It's not about a politics that wants to be cynical, because look, the thing that excites me about our generation and young people in this country is for so long, politics has been based on this foundation and this mindset of scarcity. Oh, that if you're graduating, that means I can't graduate. If you have healthcare, that means I don't have healthcare. If you have a job, it means you must be taking mine. But what I see from young people across this country is we reject that. And we accept the reality of abundance, that my success is your success and that your success is my success. And it's about a politics. And this is what I tell my constituents at home. The first thing I tell them when I speak somewhere is I say, I love you. And I remember afterwards, I had an older lady came up to me. She said, boy, I've never heard a politician say, I love you before. It felt kind of weird. And I said, well, I love you, man. Because if you love somebody, you want them to have health care. If you love someone, you want them to live free of gun violence. If you love somebody, you want them to have all the opportunities that they deserve. And that love is what's missing from our politics and from everything these days. And that's what gives me hope for the future of this country. And this message isn't just for the graduates, it's for everybody here. Don't just step into your power, use it. Because I know this wasn't easy. Many had to work two or three jobs to be here. I remember running my campaign. Candidates don't get paid to run for office. I quit my job to run. I drove Uber at night. I worked on my campaign from 9 a.m. to 10 p.m., drove Uber till about 3 to 4 a.m. just to pay my bills. Ran a horrible credit card debt. I'm still in debt. I got bad credit. And for everyone who might be asking, people know me for two reasons. I'm the first Gen Z member of Congress, and when I came to D.C., I couldn't afford an apartment. But what I want to tell everybody is, I found a place. It is all good. Now it's time to work on everybody else. But I know this wasn't easy. Whether it was multiple jobs, the work you had to do, student debt, which let me take a pause. Yes, our generation has crushing student debt. It's not because we lived beyond our means, it's because we've been denied the means to live. And it's important that everyone realize that. But besides what struggles we may experience, we can't be bitter about it. We have to fight for the world that we deserved and that the people coming after us deserve. Because in the words of the late, great Congresswoman Barbara Jordan, what the people want is simple. A country as great as its promise. And I see that promise in front of me today in every single one of these graduates, in the family and friends that have come here today. And I just want to tell everybody here, teachers, faculty, parents, family, friends, thank you for the grace and love that you've given these graduates. Thank you for the grace and love you've given these graduates here today. It's one of my greatest honors to deliver this commencement today. And to the graduates and everybody here, I love you. Because in the grand mosaic of humanity, we are all family on this earth. And the beautiful thing is, and I know there's a lot of pressure when you graduate or, you know, from an institution, there's a lot of pressure for you to figure everything out real quick. The beautiful thing is we're all just figuring it out. I mean, hell, God knows I am. And so continue to fight. Continue to see the world through the eyes of the most vulnerable. And it's an honor to be here with everybody today. Thank you so much to President Mason, the Board of Trustees, the entire faculty and staff for having me. This is a tremendous honor. 2023 graduates, congratulations on stepping into your power. Hold your head high, because many of us come from a people who have been hated and oppressed for over 400 years, yet have taught the world so much what it means to love. Take that love no matter where you go. Hold your head high, because no one can take that away from you. Much love. Love and God bless. Thank you.
Well, did we pick the right speaker or what? Congressman, that was great. Thank you for the message. I think it is exactly what our graduates needed to hear as they step forth to take on the world. Thank you very much. Just let me catch my breath for a second. Now, I would like to welcome to the podium our 2023 student commencement speaker, Mr. Eugene Thornton, a senior architecture major in the College of Agriculture, Urban Sustainability and Environmental Sciences. While at UDC, he served as the 2022-23 UDC Chapter Vice President for the National Organization of Minority Architects, where he mentors students on design, leadership, and communication skills needed to enhance student success and build fierce competitors. Eugene is passionate about value-inclusive design and building an architectural career to foster quality of life for his community. Eugene is a scholar, practitioner, and lifelong learner who plans to practice for a year, then return to UDC to complete his Master of Architecture degree needed for licensure. Eugene.
Thank you, President Mason. Good morning, distinguished guests, faculty, family, friends, and most importantly, the illustrious class, University of District of Columbia, class of 2022 and 2023. It is my honor to speak as a commencement speaker for this special occasion. I was told I'm the first College of Agriculture an urban sustainability architecture student to perform this role. And I must say, unfortunately, I might be the last, seeing as the headache I gave to Dr. Beckett and Dr. France repeatedly, you know, submitting my drafts. Unfortunately, I thought the draft was supposed to be a drawing up here, but they told me it was supposed to be a speech. It took me a while to realize that. So, now first, I would like to thank President Mason for his tremendous contribution to UDC over his 8-year tenure. It seems this graduating class was so wonderful, he decided that this is enough, I'm done, I can't do this anymore, and he decided to retire. So, seriously though, I would like to thank you as part of the class. To the faculty that guided us, thank you for your patience and diligence, and for gifting us with the tools to succeed and create a better future. To our families, loved ones, and friends, we thank you for being here with us, and for your support to us during this journey, as we celebrate not only our academic achievements, but the unique and challenging paths that we all endured soaring to new heights. And I want to ask my classmates to take a moment to shake hands and thank their colleagues to their left and their right. Now I do this because I want to emphasize, more so than other, during my time at UDC, I witnessed a special bond that formed amongst the student body. A bond that drove us through the years, a determination, a drive, a will to succeed and support each other. A bond that helped us not only let anything physically or mentally lead us astray from our path to be here walking across this stage today. And I think back to the spring of 2020, when halfway through the semester, the world was sent into chaos and literally shut down by the COVID pandemic. We were forced to adapt to alternative forms of learning that came with our introduction of countless message boards, threads, group chats on multiple platforms, and a myriad of internet video conferencing services, and the numerous content sharing applications that we had to rapidly become acquainted with from course to course, semester to semester, and year to year. Or even more recently, with our full return to campus this past year, as we tried to regain a sense of normalcy that no longer felt so normal for many of us. And then you would hear the music playing, and you would look outside your window and see people laughing and dancing in Dinar Plaza. And you may even decide to go down and have a conversation, or one, or two, or three, with some colleagues while you wait in line for an hour to get some jerk chicken off the food truck. But it was moments like this that provided us with a much needed sense of community that helped ease the transition back. And now, as the emergency of COVID is ending, so does this phase of our academic career. And as we leave the laboratories, lecture halls, and studios behind to transition the knowledge we have acquired into the workforce or our continued scholarly pursuits, we take a moment to bring with us the memories that we shared online and in person during this unprecedented experience. And to remember to always press forward and carry the spirit of camaraderie that we shared during these past years, because no Firebird stands alone. And this is the time when we rise and become leaders committed to serving our nation and communities. It is our turn to step up and take on the responsibility of navigating society towards an inclusive future for all. One that provides equal and equitable access to resources and opportunities. A future where the American dream is no longer a dream, but a reality. To do so, we must stay vigilant, continue learning, work passionately, and purposefully. Whether we are architects or artists, engineers or educators, lawyers or continuing scholars, now is our time to inspire greatness, empower innovation, and serve community. Thank you, and congratulations to the classes of 2022 and 2023.
Thank you for those words to your fellow classmates, Mr. Thornton. Moreover, thank you for being a shining example of a UDC Firebird. We will now be favored with a musical selection entitled I Look to the Hills, performed by soloist Jay Jacobs, along with the University of the District of Columbia's chorale, under the direction of Professor Johnny Butler, accompanied by Professor Evelyn Simpson Currington.
Let me run, my God, and strength,
and strength,
and Lord,
and Lord.
Let's give Ms. Jacobs and the UDC Corral another round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, we have now come to the conferring of degrees and the awarding of diplomas. President Mason, it is my pleasure and privilege as the Chief Academic Officer of the University of the District of Columbia to present the candidates here assembled who have qualified in all respects for their respective degree programs. They have been recommended by the faculty and confirmed by the Board of Trustees to be awarded appropriate degrees in recognition of their academic accomplishments. Will all faculty representatives of the degree programs being conferred this morning from across the six colleges and schools please stand? All faculty, please stand. President Mason, the faculty and I are pleased to present these candidates who will qualify as appropriate for the following degrees: Doctor of Philosophy, Juris Doctorate, Master of Architecture, Master of Science, Master of Arts, Master of Arts in Teaching, Master in Business Administration, Professional Science Master, Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Music, Bachelor of Social Work, Associate of Arts, Associate of Science, and Associate of Applied Science degrees. Will the candidates for the Doctor of Philosophy in the College of Agriculture, Urban Sustainability and Environmental Sciences, and the School of Engineering and Applied Sciences, the Juris Doctor in the UDC David A. Clark School of Law, Master's degrees in the College of Arts and Sciences, School of Business and Public Administration, School of Engineering and Applied Sciences, College of Agriculture, Urban Sustainability and Environmental Sciences, please rise and remain standing. Will the candidates for baccalaureate degrees in the College of Arts and Sciences please rise and remain standing? Will the candidates for baccalaureate degrees in the School of Business and Public Administration please rise and remain standing? Will the candidates for the baccalaureate degrees in the School of Engineering and Applied Sciences please rise and remain standing? Will the candidates for the baccalaureate degrees in the College of Agriculture, Urban Sustainability and Environmental Sciences please rise and remain standing? Will the candidates for the associate degrees in the University of the District of Columbia's Community College please rise and remain standing?
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the University of the District of Columbia, and upon the recommendation of the faculty, with the endorsement of the Chief Academic Officer, I confer upon you the degree Doctor of Philosophy, Juris Doctor, Master's, Baccalaureate, and Associate's degrees from the University of the District of Columbia, according to the department in which you have qualified, with all honors, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. And now, as a sign of graduate, sign of being a graduate, and because it is the tradition of this president to graduate with each new graduating class. Will the baccalaureate and associate degree graduates please move your tassels from the right to the left side of your caps? Now, graduates, please be seated. I now present my esteemed colleague, Professor Devdas Shetty, Dean of the School of Engineering and Applied Sciences.
Will the recipients of Doctor of Philosophy from the School of Engineering and Applied Sciences please rise and come forward?
Temechu Zudi. Vincent Tano. Juan F. Ramirez Rochak.
Will the PhD degree recipients please be seated? President Mason, I have the honor of presenting to you my esteemed colleague, Dr. Dwayne Jones, Dean of the College of Agriculture, Urban Sustainability, and Environmental Sciences, CASES.
Will the recipients of the Doctor of Philosophy in the College of Agriculture, Urban Sustainability, and Environmental Sciences please rise and come forward?
Carletta Sabrina Hurt. Camille Paris Range.
Will the PhD recipients from the College of Agriculture, Urban Sustainability, and Environmental Sciences please be seated? President Mason, I have the honor of presenting to you my esteemed colleague, Dr. Toinette Johnson, Acting Dean of the David A. Clark School of Law.
Will the recipients of the Juris Doctor in the University of the District of Columbia, David A. Clark School of Law, rise and please come forward? Nija Anise Bestfield. Dr. Tanya Michelle Harris. Sarah Jane Blazuki. Asia Dion Hartgrove. Taylor Mariah Rogers. Joe's John Baptiste. Alexis McNeil. Woo! David Daniel Bennett. Woo!
Sean Chow. Fenyon Ujamu Stewart. Shaquana Rulwit Nicole Woolridge. Brittany Smith Harding. Gabriel Herman. Jamise Loge Simone Hawkins. Avion Olasumbo Macharia Shutan. Korea Alicia Hicks. Winona Walker Edwards. Laura Suzanne Newman. Jennifer C. Tindy. Andrea Stephanie De La Torre. Will the degree recipients from the UDC David A. Clark School of Law please be seated? President Mason, I have the honor of presenting to you my esteemed colleague, Dr. April Mason, Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences.
Will recipients of master's and baccalaureate degrees in the College of Arts and Sciences please rise and come forward?
Tiffany Salita Reed. Deja Tatiana Bullock. Stacy Elaine Unona.
Go, Stacy.
Tommy L. Woodbury Bellamy. Munta Kema Singho Abdul Kunduz. Karam Eloise Foster. B. Johnny Turley. Sumoya Imani Crisp. Rolanda Petit Boys. Lachelle Renee Taylor. Christian Reed Johnson. Danielle Asha Lee Robinson. Joshua Nathan Lofton. Jade Iman Jacobs. Cherie E. Latson. Olufa Lajimi O. Gabadamosi. Alina Busamat. Talia Alicia Jackson. Jamil Nadir Ali Halden. Nicole Victoria Thomas. Amber Dene Glover. Andrea D. Swanson. India T. Witcher. Vanille C. Palmer Hall. Brianna Naomi Walker. Carolina Marina de la Parra de Luna. Dakota Raven Cruz. Juan Carlos Turcios Lobato. Jamie Lee Younger. Lakita Ann Coates. Desiree Soleil Geckler. Ebony Monique Bennett. Bob Yanda Loseke King Gombe. Maya Samantha Smith. Harriet Chibugo Ukwando. Jane Nkechi Wafor. Jima Kinte. Simone Parn. Kelly Francina Lee. Amari Taji Yvonne Dorian Holmes. Antoine Dontrell Young. Garrett Lewis Thomas. Jessica Michelle Villatoro Santos. Vanity Von Minis Miller. Mark Anton Johnson. Janetta Nicole Sams. Dikla Mashia. Sequita Dominique Tolliver. Dejanae Sonia Imani Miller. Sadeja Kayla Marie Keith. Akeem A. Franklin. Evisha Chanel Grosset. Matherine Melanie Zama Zitti. Polanle Sara Akinola. Queen Esther May Pollard. Allie Lauren Swanson. Herbert Luis Romero Gomez. Jody L. Ricks. Josiane Jepmo Simo. Bethlehem Chekole. Ponrima Sonia Aileen Selu. Deborah Joanne Wells. Okay, Takia Germaine Bridgeforth. Jonathan Lee Butler. Ayub Mujtahi. Wanda Majeng, Shonkolo Asemak. Lika. Lika. Lika Melaku Gelaje. Taleja G. Shirley. Marquis King. Edmund Alton Smith Sr. Tomasina Williams. Kimberly Woods. Elizabeth Sivers Sorobook. Invasia Nicole Jefferson.
Thank you.
Alexandria Marie Da Costa. Adonis Otoniel Garcia Garcia. August Valentin. Naika Diaz Hicks. Kaylin Renee Kelly. Daisy Zacualpa Mozo. Christy Benedict Hill. Celeste Maria Smallwood. Gina Faye Scales Johnson. Marcus Eugene Bisco. Sean Brown Laster. Salim Adolfo. Virginia Esperanza Cruz de Montoya. Taylor Ann Robinson. Bria Brown. Sarah Ann Nestor.
Go.
Jasmine N. Pollard. Lisa G. Robinson. Chanel Lenise Janice Hawkins. Jaquit Randiam Bololona. Daniel Earl Powell. Coplian Sencali. Diana Natalie Fuentes Rosales. Jasmine Kimberly Holly. Latonya Janice Dickens. Mabel Sia Bangai. Tracy Laverne Lucas. Quishon Monette Wallace. Meredith Laverne Davis. Maureen Serena Bethia Ashton. Douglas Daniel Pineda. Arian Day Duval. Lindsay Alexander Jolly. Okay, Latisha Danielle Batwell. Winifred L. Thomas. Thomas Allen Cecile. Maxwell E. Hansberry. Kenlon Akoria Mitchell. Michael A. Cofield. Alejandra Giboni. Claudia Araceli Martinez. Tiara Monet Shorts. Tanjanika T. Smith. Kimesha Lavon, Merchant. Rosetta Mayhall. Tamara Louise Cook. Leroy Thomas Ellis Jr. Abi Laya Talmud. Najee Jones. Okivia Sanisha Price. Eugenia M. Bagley. Bradley Dorcellus. Kevin Mateo Espinosa. Lilian Flores Lopez. Netmi Tasiwa Amarasingwe. Ayjane M. Putney. Dejane Terrell. Brianna Deshae Smith. Paula McCown Epps. Kimani Hunter. Jonsei Tyleek Chambers. Javier Abadía Torres. John Reynolds. Andy Eduardo Ventura. Marcelina Manzano. Nathan Jonathan Cousins. Senizia Quenisha Robertson. Jordan Bond. Brittany Latrice Woodward. Saint Louis Curtis Thomas. Jameer Julius Marable Williams. Alam Abdul Rashid Hassan. Michael S. Henderson. Catherine Tirado. Jaquela Brittany Smallwood. Crystal Nicole Fouch. John Argueta. Jonathan Fuentes. Tyler Allen Jensen. Melita Amanda West. Maria Carla Avila. Kintu Amiri McLeod. Paris Wilton.
Go ahead.
Brittany Boland. Jerise Ann Bryant. Eric Quinteros. Waikinia Dewan Gillespie. Naomi Desaleng. Delante L. Cliet, Jr. Devin Monique Phillips. Ojane A. Finch. Jasmine Ruth Romero Castillo. Kiara Angeli Romero. Marcia Sayeda Husaini. Venicia Ferguson.
go ahead.
Kyra Lanise Shade.
Will the recipients of degrees in the College of Arts and Sciences please be seated? President Mason, I have the honor of presenting my esteemed colleague, Dr. Mohammed Safiri, Dean of the School of Business and Public Administration.
Good morning. Will the recipients of master's and baccalaureate degrees from a School of Business and Public Administration rise and come forward?
Andreas LeVar Smith. Jake Bedforth. Giovanni Barahona. Danielle D. Smallwood. Olianka M. Wingate. Dolores Nzang Bivini Ayakaba. Elmer A. Turcios. That got out of order. She's Chanel. Chanel? Yes, she is. Chanel Tejera Hibbert. And who's he? Ahmad? Is he Ahmad? Ahmad Magdi Rashid.
Go ahead, go up.
Hera San Tun O. Josie Akwazauku. Katie Yisel Lazo. Dennis A. Moreno. Alexander Ciccone. Eric Ryan Fear Brett. Agustin Alvarado Montes. Jonisa Imani Green. Leander Lee Manzano. Nancy Stephanie Sorto Romero. Javorn Ricardo Gray. Ngozi. Brianna Ngozi Alexandria Hartley. Tyreek Carl Thompson. Tessima Girma Shakur Mir. Kevin Davis. Josue Daniel Pena Ramirez. Victor Samuel Zelaya. Chiquita Lee. Halia Anaya Ellis. Oh.
Shanae Tracy Ann Burke. Louis Mangion. Mauricio Jose Corti Sosa. Matthew L. Miller. Carnell L. Lofton, Jr. Eduardo de Oliveira Bugay. Jorge Alberto Silva. Kenick Elvir Corrales. Morgan Livingston. Jayla Clarice Hutchinson. Jayla LaBelle Tolliver. Mwanu Nebujali. Silenus Rodriguez Palmore. Candace D. White. Donna McNeil. Bonita Harrison. Tracy Williams. Give it back. Laniqua Dominique Jenkins. Laura Ann Smith. Valerie Person. Shanika C. Wilson. Beverly Welch Barrow. Lakeisha Denise Breithaupt. Cameron Joy Rogers. Andrea Gonzalez. Brittany Annalisa Duncan. Asia Williams. Okay, go ahead. Zulema Uoya Santos. Nolanda Graves. Arlene Fairley Marshall. Evelyn Eileen Bryant. Benjamin P. Lasso. Nana Ose Ampaido. St- Stacy Sambria Jensen. Tierra Alice Allen. Manda Chanel Burnham. Anastasia N. Campbell. Mulu Tesfai. Duet Sean Carr. Daryl Ronaldo Bartley. Antoine Shavar Brady. Emily Brittany Osborne. Grace Alicia Yepes. Kayla Venable. Cindy Hernandez. Maria Alejandra Garcia. Nicole Justine West.
Will the degree recipients in the School of Business and Public Administration be seated? President Mason, I have the honor of presenting my esteemed colleague, Dr. Devdas Shetty, Dean of the School of Engineering and Applied Sciences.
Will the recipients of master's and baccalaureate degrees from School of Engineering and Applied Sciences please rise and come forward?
Rahel Shafar Gizal. Jana Christina Katucci. All right. Betahim N. Engesha. Marilyn L. Andrade Guillen. Patricia Bobrin Reese.
Hayden Brown.
Hayden Brown. Ryan J. Walker. Steve Tegu. Daryl Devario Kelly Jr. Ty Ojene Roseburg. Gloria M. Hernandez. Ronnie Andre Romero Melendez. Malatu Casa Bochoro. Dorian Reven Davis. All right. Ch- Chance Orion Eden. Matthew Anthony R. Brown. Jason Saul Alberti. Daniel Aaron Washington. Isa Abdul Razak Jinko. Corey John Carter. Boss T.A. Harrigan Jr. Marcus Edward Gilmore the First. Damani Christian Tolson.
Kawama? Okay.
Kawama Bayani Uga.
Hanan.
Hanan Muhammad Berta.
Adrian?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Adrian Denise Lambert.
Tasneem. Okay.
Tasneem Abdus Shakur.
Bashira.
Bashira Abdus Shakur.
Janaya.
Janaya Simone Cromer Butler.
Glacia? Okay. All right.
Glacia Rosan Martin. Trent Donald Peterson. Nicholas PKE Yankee.
Caleb.
Okay. All right.
Caleb Getachu Asifa.
Indalkachu. Okay.
Indalkachu Bekele Guwara.
Michael Messman. Okay.
Michael Mesfin Amemaya Hale.
I know I missed that. No idea.
Hervé Cabrel Sanja Chamba. Hans Matthew De Bias.
Box, okay.
David Box Garcia.
Juan. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Juan Estevez Hernandez.
Hamza
Abedel Cis.
Albedas Basi, okay.
Abdul Basit Al Telha. Orlando O. Bowman. Vance Michael Warren Jr.
Kaim.
Kaim Mark Anthony Anderson.
Sarah Pop.
All right. Sarah Pop from Sava. Bailey Sanborn Garfield.
Wanchet.
Wanchet A. Tegegni.
Okay.
Esther Menkan Disam. Sugre Noma Flavi Stephanie Raumba.
Fumba.
Arnold Kevin Fumba. Orbiora Victor Mbanefu. Tizare Asanda Walker.
Josue
Alngar Ventura.
Joshua Allen.
Joshua Allen.
Christine
George Anna. Shivani Mehta.
Anuj
Sharma. Deontay Amari Hicks. Javon L. Harriet.
Dion
A. Taylor. Julio Cesar Martin Castro. Demario Askett. Alan Alfonso Muir. Italia Viola Taylor. Tori Nicole Walker.
Steffi Graham. Graham.
Steffi Graham. Alia Agabrelli, newbie. Javar Charlton Dougal. Alexi Devon Taylor. Carlos Miguel Palancia Flores. Christian Ananga Abini. Temeskin Atna Alameu Sr.
The degree recipients from the School of Engineering and Applied Sciences, please be seated. President Mason, I have the honor of presenting to you my esteemed colleague, Dr. Dwayne Jones, Dean of the College of Agriculture, Urban Sustainability, and Environmental Sciences, CASES.
Will the recipients of the master's and baccalaureate degrees from the College of Agriculture, Urban Sustainability, and Environmental Sciences please rise and come forward?
Janelle Laura Dunn. Glendy Beatrice Maldonado Hernandez. Montego Thousand. Shauna White. Lydia Kidane. Kenya Sheree Norris. Alfred Lewis Brooks Jr. Denisha Koch. Adele L. Barber the Fourth. Cassia Aaliyah West. Jocelyn Cruz. Andre Williams. Annabelle Lyra Arnold. Tyrone Grant. Jacob Cecile Campbell. Rose Keate.
Okay.
Christopher Adozi Awariabor. Tiara Chanel Price. Nancy Irias. Regina Iona Smalls. All right. Danelle S. Carby. Simi Braden Stanford. Bethany Rachel Lee. Congrosal Bumdelger. Davida Kuhn. Okay. Pamela Medrano Otero. Sabrina Michelle Roberts.
Simon Levi
Bernstead. I'm sorry, what was your name?
Miranda O'Carry.
Miranda O'Carry.
Elmer Sorto Correas.
Elmer Sorto Correas. Kyle J. Cummings. Okay. Rahel A. Demisi.
Okay,
Mektis. Okay. Mektis G. Achetti. Okay. Eugene Edward Thornton Jr.
Will the degree recipients from the University of the District of Columbia's College of Agriculture, Urban Sustainability, and Environmental Sciences please be seated? President Mason, I have the honor of presenting to you my esteemed colleague, Dr. Marilyn Hamilton, Dean of the UDC Community College.
Will the recipients of associate degrees in the University of the District of Columbia Community College please rise and come forward?
Malet Getachew Bene. Madeline Martinez Marquez.
I called your name. What's your name?
Kiara Yvonne Rogers. Quintina Purnell. Sonia Amaya Cruz. Veronica Beatrice Fuentes Ardon. Rosa Maribel Berrios de Ochoa. Nelly Maria Ventura Martinez.
Danica Short.
Danica Short.
Shanika Chavon.
Shanika Chavon Somerville.
Deirdre May.
Deidre May. Jessica Bryant.
Farrell.
Amber Danielle Farrell. Artemio Rivera. Ayman Abdulaziz Aisha. Hafiz Sabir Hafsala.
Madison Elizabeth Gady.
Madison Elizabeth Gady.
Tanya
Diane Clark.
Destiny A.
Gilmore.
Asia
Nichelle Archie. Michelle Noni Person. Kanita Rosario Wilson. Justine Selena Blanco. Juliana Modupe Adewumi. Josefa Perez Reyes. Yemi Yuli Cespedes de Ramos. Araceli Mendez Mendez. Leslie Yesenia Paz. Michael Hardy III. Aisha X. Hicks. Angel Harris. Gladys Christina Ramos. Tariq D. Sadiq. Patrice Danielle Richardson. Kayla Edith Cody. Shayla Tashawn Bozier. Stephanie Uzochi Onyeneho. Tanika Yvette Hunter. Candace Monique Bruce. Patrick L. Herb Jr. Kali Caroline Smallwood. Maheder Bekele Gurara. Chaltu Bersisa Guteta. Kevin D. Balale. Esther Tulowani Oluboale. Amber A. Thompson. Zuri Akiba Price. Priscilla N. Wiggleton. Elsa Pochi. Audrey Marie Oninico. Mestowet W. Dejene. Meseret Abebe. Glenda Lisseth Mendoza. Roxana Erily Benitez Machado. Jacqueline Johanna Diaz Lopez. Marta Jimenez Salvador. Alessandra Gahum Mariano. Irina Miklovanka Tate.
Hasna.
Hasna El Azraq.
Abinet Alemu.
Abinet Alemu Wolde Michel.
Jane
Ulunma Chimezi. Tesfa Adam Mulat Admasu. Chetachuku N. Ozochuku.
Dereje
Hordofa Babo. Mesfin Teferi Gamechu. Marcel Galeon. Jessica D. Valencia Leon. Alicia Morales Escobar. Rosa Ivette Martinez de Riviera. Nico D. Jones.
Jamel
Brian Thomas.
Deja
Hilliard.
She didn't tell me. Nayeli.
Nayeli Zapata Arismendi. Malik Isaiah Loggins.
It's Clark D. Long.
Clark D. Long. Montez Acham Lewis Peters. Jonathan Parker.
Rachel J. Stinson.
Shelly LaVon Rhodes.
Aaliyah Elijah Howard.
Aaliyah Elijah Howard.
Maisha Howard.
Maisha Howard.
Oh my goodness.
Ebony Shaniqua
McIver. Ebony Shaniqua McIver.
Crystal Renee.
Go girl.
Crystal Renee Limscomb.
Go Crystal.
Elise Lachey Kennedy.
Alice Lachey Kennedy Butler.
Tranel Nelshawn Cox.
Yes!
Tranel Nelshawn Cox.
Tanisha Janea.
Go, Tranel! All right. Go, Alice!
Tranisha Janea Terry. Michelle Bennett.
Gabriel Brianna.
Gabriel Brianna Barnes. Jasmine Alicia Woods.
Charmaine
Denise Becton.
Shalen Prince.
Shalen Prince. Emmett Wesley Johnson.
Natalie Bermudez Ramos.
Hannah Haptu Regasa. Anna M. Martinez de Bercian. Sylvia Mabley Hernandez Paz. Maria Carolina Rodriguez.
Maria Romano.
Maria A. Romano.
Beatriz Roque.
Concepcion Beatriz Roque. Rosa Aidi Aguao Agudelo.
Andrea.
Andrea Paola Alfonso Carillo.
Sonia Canaviri.
Sonia E. Canaviri Chacon. Elsa Miriam Argueta Canales.
Guillermina Perez.
Guillermina Perez.
Sonia Yanira Grijalva.
Sonia Yanira Rivala.
Mariama Conte.
Mariama Conte!
Tanisha. That's my baby. Tanisha.
Tanisha Alexia Pearsall.
Shanae Zarkia.
Shanae Zarkia Hunter.
Yes.
Ronald Art Walton III.
Middle name is Tyree.
Catherine Tyree Morris.
Bianca B. Garnett.
Bianca B. Garnett.
Daryl Glenda Barbour.
Daryl Glenda Barbour. Jonathan Charles Moody.
Raymond Tate.
Raymond Tate.
Yay, Raymond!
Serena.
Serena Renee McBride.
Chantresa.
Zanitra Hester.
Nassim Youssef. Myra.
Mayra El Barrientos.
You can sing it. Okay.
Irma Zul Yolanda Zul de Morales.
Dina
E. Guillen.
Linda. Okay, great.
Glenda M. Molina Guevara. Denise Jasmine Herrera de Gomez. Zaira P. Realagueno de Villegas. Hortensia Yesenia Vargas Bardales. Mercedes Garcia Correa. Paula E. Urquizo Tituana. Ava N. Vasquez Gomez.
Jahaira.
Jahaira Venegas Vega. Santana Rodriguez. Stanley Ulises Gonzalez Moran. Jocelyn Johanna Reyes Martinez.
Esmera Sique.
Doritha A. Peterson.
Asmera Sique.
Sigue.
Okay. Sigue.
Asmera Tsige.
Okay.
Marina del Carmen Irajeta. Tiffany C. Johnson. Terry Latanya Bell. Devarian M. Brown.
William Thomas Watson III. Daniel E. Phillips. LaShawn Nicole Melton. Chelsea Beatrice Franklin. Elmer Alexander Umana Jimenez.
Maria Sluin.
Maria Sluin.
Felicity Aaron Boris.
Okay. Felicity Aaron Boris. Simenesh Makengo. Seyum Woldais Mamuye. Meskaram E. Desta. Yemisrash J. G. Tadese.
All right, Minyot. Minyot.
Minyot.
Just do the first and last.
Minyot Yamlaksira Gezagen.
Thank you. Abundage.
Abundage. Abundage M. Gebeyehu.
Eden.
Eden Demli Akalu. Laurentina Marino Ramirez. Brianna Maritza Reyes Vasquez. Diamond Verschel Blackany. Chantel Blanton. Jasmine Nicole Dill. Yodi M. Lopez Ramirez. Kevin Kennedy.
Aisha.
Aisha. Aisha Lorraine Richburg.
Duran.
Duran. Duran Uzel Evans. Ayana Nelson. Charity DeAngelique Williams.
Amima.
Amima Del Carmen Mejia. Milena Ramirez Oviedo. Victoria Michelle Lancaster. Lisa Marie Cole.
Deshila.
Deshila Sharon Wallace.
Thank you. Christian.
Christian Lee Brown.
Kenya.
Kenya.
Kenya Brianna Henry.
Congratulations.
Michuta Catherine Wilkins.
Tanith.
Tanise James. Andrea Lisette Martinez Ardon. Milagro Araceli Vieira Lemus. Roxana Maribel Orellana. Jennifer Marisol Solis. Jessica Areli Abarca. Pernell Wingate Jr. Dua Bukhari. Santos Benjamin Flores Franco. Nicholas Dorsey Brown. Zena Burleigh.
Jacqueline?
Yes, Jacqueline.
Jacqueline.
Jacqueline de Moraes Reis. Marley Lopez Manzano Manuel. Betty Yadira Nava Claros. Hugo Chukwu Aniekwe.
Misha Meiser.
What?
Misha Meiser.
Misha Meisel.
Shanasia.
Shanasia Brown. Tyler Michelle Reed.
They said the wrong name for the president, so she is the president. We should say it. UDC Community College SJ President.
Kanisha. And the UDC Community College Student Government Association President, Kanisha J. Toy.
Will the associate degree recipients of the University of the District of Columbia Community College please be seated?
Ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present the University of the District of Columbia class of 2023. Very good. This is my best graduating class yet. Now please welcome Bernard Grayson Jr., a UDC alumnus and president of the National Alumni Society, who will induct our 2023 graduates as new alumni.
Allow me to extend my sincere congratulations to the class of 2023 of the University of the District of Columbia. If you will turn in your program to page 30, as you are officially inducted into the family of the University of the District of Columbia alumni, together we will recite the oath of honor. I messed that up. I do solemnly vow and affirm that as an alumni or alumnus of the University of the District of Columbia, I will do everything in my power to foster the spirit of intelligent inquiry in this university and the brotherhood of man in the community in which I live and work. I will act to preserve these attributes at all times. I do solemnly vow and affirm that as an alumnus of the University of the District of Columbia, I will propagate and otherwise support the goals of the university and will give moral, mental, and financial support without reservation. I will willingly and to the fullest extent of my means, I will, in the interest of UDC, assume the obligation freely without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion, so help me God. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Graduates, you are about to embark on lives of service to a society that desperately needs you. During your time at UDC, you have fulfilled your aspirations and accomplished much. And so, if we have done our job as we walk this journey together, you leave here transformed and ready to take on the world. Dream dreams, big and small. Continue to grow as people, as professionals, as human beings. Commit that each new day, you will be better than the one day before. Love each other. Remember, yesterday is only a memory, and tomorrow is only a vision. But if you take care of each other each day and make it the very best day you can, then every yesterday will be a memory of happiness, and every tomorrow will be a vision of hope. To the Firebird family, I can honestly say each day of my 8 years here has been a happy memory, and each graduating class has given me greater hope for the future. With love and respect, I thank you all for the best 8 years of my professional life. Go forth, Firebirds, and bring hope to the world. I want to thank all of the Commencement Committee members, faculty, staff, and student volunteers under the leadership of Dr. Malva Reed, Dr. Wynn Yarborough, and Mr. Lee Brian Reba, co-chairs of the committee, and Dr. Lawrence Potter for their vigorous work in putting together this program. Now the audience will stand and join in the singing of the Alma Mater, led by the UDC Chorale. It is printed on page 31 of the commencement program.
Thank you. We have heard clearly that indeed this is a class of diversity. 21 countries represented, and we're blessed to have seen them walk across the stage in memory and in great adoration. Remembering your tradition, let's pray. We've heard many times, O God, about love. For love suffers long and is kind. Love envies not. Love vaunts not itself. It's not puffed up, does not behave itself unseemly, seeks not her own. And so as we take this with us, we ask, O God, that you would go with us, stand by us, and protect us, and deliver us to the places where you want us to be. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling, and to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever. Again, in Jesus' name, let us all say, amen.
Will the audience please be seated and remain seated until the platform, guests, faculty, and graduates have cleared the arena. Thank you all, one and all, for making this commencement celebration a memorable occasion for the University of the District of Columbia's distinguished class of 2023. I hereby declare this commencement ceremony ended. Have a wonderful early Mother's Day. Congratulations, Firebirds. Thank you.